Hello and welcome in today's exciting episode. I make some vintage jumper dresses from this simplicity pattern.
It's perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Perfect jacket.
So here we have the simplicity vintage jumper dress, S9449. And this red one with the big pockets and the full skirt is the one that I like. And I was going to make it in this plum fabric. It's just a plain yarn dyed one, but it's not quite enough fabric. So I have this wine colored one, and it's about a yard more of fabric, so that I'll easily be able to make it out of this one. So I cut out all the pieces. Annoyingly, there's four pieces in the skirt, which means there's a center front seam, two side seams, and back center back seam. Annoying, but what can you do? And then these are the two front pieces. There's a massive dart in the side there, hence that arrow triangle cutout. And those are the back ones. The pin just marks the massive dart in that one as well. And it also has pockets. This is some massive pockets, but I'm totally here for it. So yeah, you have to cut the outer and the lining. So there's actually four of those, which is why I needed the extra yard, because they're just a weird shape as well. Anyway, so all the pieces are cut out, so it is time to sew everything together. But the original version, the simplicity pattern, has a zip at the side, so it's quite fitted. And I decided I wanted a pullover version that I can, you know, if I have to go out, I can cinch it at the waist with a sash or a tie or a belt. But the rest of the time I can just wear it as a baggy dress. And so I was going to do a rose one with that. But then I also mostly like my dresses with sleeves on them. So the rose one is a true jumper dress because it doesn't have sleeves and you can just wear a shirt underneath it. Whereas this one, I mean, it's so baggy you can still wear a shirt underneath it, but it does have the puffy sleeves, so you could just wear it as a regular dress if you wanted. And I'm really glad that I finally found a use for the Minnie Mouse fabric. And I think, yeah, I really like it. I haven't put the pockets on these ones yet, just because they're circle skirts, so they're cut on the bias. So I thought, I don't know, are you supposed to let them drop for a couple of days or a week? Because the pockets, if they were just normal size pockets, patch pockets, then I wouldn't bother. But these are massive patch pockets. So they've just been sitting there for a little bit. And I'll make the original one now in the plain wine-coloured fabric. But oh, how beautiful does the rose one look when it has the 1950s netted petticoat underneath? So cute. But now we'll go back to the original pattern. So this is the one from Simplicity, just pretty much as is. I'm not using facing. I'm doing full lining for the bodice, so that's different. But apart from that, it's the pattern. And so I've got this a front outer, front lining, and then a back bodice front outer and a back bodice lining, and I just use the same fabric because I had about half a yard left. So this is the front, and they have really deep darts and they've cut out the fabric. I don't actually like doing darts because I do linings, and yeah, the bulk you get from doing a dart is doubled. So yeah, I really dislike doing darts, but anyway, I'm doing this pattern. So yeah, the two front ones and then the two back ones. They're actually quite tall, the back ones, much taller than on the usual patterns, vintage patterns that I do. Anyway, so this is me pinning the front ones, and then I'm starting to pin the back ones. And now I've done both back ones and both front ones, so it is time to get the machine out and sew them. So I sew them and then I tie the ends, but whatever your preferred method is. And once that's done, then you press them open. The back ones you press into the center and the front darts you press flat. Then the next step is to sew the side seams, but you of course have to leave a gap where the zip goes, the side closure. On the outer bodice, it's on the left, and on the inner bodice, the lining, it's on the right, because the lining is basically inside out when you wear it. Next step is to pin the outer bodice and the lining together at the V-neck, at the front and back, and also around the arms. Now, you don't do the shoulders, because if a bodice doesn't have sleeves, it's sleeveless, then you need to have the shoulders strap free to turn everything through. So just the neckline and the underarms, that's it. So you sew them. It took a while to pin, but yeah, once you've sewn it, then you turn everything out, or you clip the curves, obviously. Then you turn everything out, and I just find it easier to get the seam in the correct spot. I go around and pin it, then I press it, but whatever's easiest for you. And once that's done, you just have to hand stitch the shoulders together. So I do the outer to the outer, the front outer to the back outer, and then I do the lining second, and that way, yeah, any stitches that are seen are just on the lining side. So once you've done the bodice, it is time to get out those four pieces for the skirt. I really, really wish I'd done at least six pieces for this skirt, just having, like, I'm staring at the finished product here. But it's a nice enough skirt, but I wanted something really, really big and full, like the illustration. Anyway, so I sewed the four of them together. You have to be careful to do the center lines first, so that you don't accidentally sew the two front sides together or anything like that. So yeah, do the center front first, then do the back center, and then do the sides. But of course, you leave room for the zip on the left side. And then you pin the top of the skirt to the bottom of the bodice, and then you sew around, and then you reinforce. And here, this is me pinning the lining of the bodice to the just to hide the waistline seam, and then you hand stitch that in. And once that is done, it is time to, well, you're supposed to put the zip in, obviously, but I'm just going to skip that because I'm a little bit over this dress, because this is the third one I've made for this video. I love the other two so much, but you can see the difference between the skirts in the one on the right. Sorry, I should have taken the one in the middle out, because it's a little confusing. So the one on the right is the one I just made, and the one on the left is the rose one. So that's my version of this pattern. Basically, I just took the ruby dress bodice and made it a V-neck. I hate V-necks, but I did it anyway. And then I increased the skirt as well. And then here, because they're jumper dresses, I decided that to really test them out, I should put shirts underneath them. I like the purple shirt under the wine-coloured one, but it still looks, compared to the other two, it still looks a little bit boring. I did the plain darker plum and wine colours. I chose them because I thought they were more grown up, and they will suit me in like a decade or so. Maybe I'll become more mature, I don't know. But I'm not sure about that. But it's nice. But yeah, I mean, this one is just gorgeous. It looks like all the characters from Monsters, Inc. combined. It is so cute. I love it so much. Or the little girl who loves unicorns in Despicable Me. And this was the only shirt of mine that I made, that I finished, that I had left over. So I put that one under. It's the mushrooms one, and it's cute, but it's not really, I don't know, it kind of goes with the yellow roses, but it's a little bit boring. I would wear this one, this rose jumper dress, with like black long sleeve t-shirt underneath. So I just got out the dress that I made. It's really dark, and so this is probably what it will look like. It reminds me of that Alexander McQueen dress with all the rose petals on it. Now, I usually do a little review at the end of each video about and talk about what I liked about the pattern, but I have to say I like my version of the pattern better than this, the original, but I couldn't have got there without the original. So there is that. And I think, yeah, to be fair, this was the most boring of the three fabrics. So it was a little hard. And yeah, I love the illustration. So I wanted a really, really full skirt. I think that was a little bit of a disappointment to me. And I don't like darts, and I don't like V-necks, and I don't like sleeveless with combined with V-neck. So yeah, there were a lot of things that probably weren't great, but I really wanted to make a vintage jumper dress, and so I did. But yeah, I much prefer my pullover version of it, and that doesn't have darts and you just cinch it at the waist. I also think the fabrics that I used for these ones are just fabulous. I love the rose one. I love the polka dot one. Actually, I bought the polka dots back in November for Pretty in Pink month. And yeah, that is the best use of that fabric. It's so much fun. I have cut out all the pockets and I've sewn most of them together, and so here they are. I haven't done the wine coloured ones yet, but what you do basically is you just stitch around the edge, leaving a little gap, and then you cut the corners, and then you, as I said, you leave a gap, and then you turn them all through, and then you iron them flat and make sure the edges are right. And then you hand stitch them, and then you stitch up the little, hand stitch the little bit at the top where you pulled the whole thing through. And then you stick them onto the, pin them onto the dress and hand stitch them on. Some people machine sew them on, but if a little kid runs up and grabs your pockets, which, I mean, they're little kids, they just like to be picked up, then I prefer hand stitching, because that way the pocket comes off and the whole dress doesn't rip. But you know, you do you. So as I said, I made these skirts a lot fuller than the original pattern, so I'm not sure how a big pocket is going to go over so much fabric at the top. I didn't really think about that. I guess I can make a handbag with them if they don't work, or like a little purse with them or something. But I'm kind of pretty determined to stick them on there. So I'll just let the dress drop for, I don't know, a couple more days or a week. They're quilting fabrics that I use. They're pretty robust, so I don't think they're going to drop that much. You sort of have to worry about cutting on the bias, like circle skirts with more volatile fabrics. Quilting cottons are pretty stable, they're pretty sturdy. So yeah, anyway, those are my three dresses, and yeah, I obviously have two clear favorites. But I think I'll probably like the other one, grow to like the other one as well. But the other ones are just so adorable. I love that combination with the shirt underneath it and that pretty floral sash around the middle. That is so cute. So thank you very much for watching. I had so much fun making these two dresses, but then I just kept putting off this wine coloured one. I put it off for so long. You ended up seeing the sewing vlog because I just kept putting it off. But anyway, so thank you for watching. And yeah, I definitely recommend making a jumper dress. They are just so much fun because you get to work out all different combinations. This mushrooms and forest critters shirt is growing on me. I kind of like that combination. It's understated. This one is hilarious. I love this combination so much. It's just adorable. Anyway, thank you again for watching. Happy sewing.